So I might be the original nomad developer. I've been writing code since 1994, and I've never had a job working for someone as a coder. I was always either an independent contractor and or a freelancer and SaaS owner. So there is an allure to being a developer, that's for sure. There's an allure in terms of the freedom, in terms of the flexibility in your schedule. And that is all true, but nothing is perfect. Let me give you the pros and cons of being a nomad developer, freelance developer, and you can decide if it's for you, because largely, whether you want to be a freelance developer, a big part of it is personal choice and how you like to work. So let's jump into it. So number one, if you're going to be a freelance nomad developer, you have to have the ability to be self-motivated, to be able to know when to work and when not to work, believe it or not. You don't want to burn yourself out. So yes, you have to have that ability to be self-motivated, to be disciplined enough to be able to actually get the work done on time and not to overwork yourself. So that's first of all, you have to think about that. Are you that type of person? Can you motivate yourself? Number two, you need to be able to create your own structure and framework. One of the advantages of working for somebody is you walk into a job and everything is laid out for you, exactly what you have to do, how you have to do it, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Whereas when you're freelancing or you're a nomad developer, you have to set that up yourself. You have to define your own structures, work ethic, et cetera, et cetera. It's related to being self-motivated, but it's also, again, one of the reasons a lot of people have trouble getting up and running as a freelancer or nomad developer is that they don't have a structure that they could lean upon. If enough people comment on this video, I'll put out a video on how to structure your nomad slash nomad developer slash freelance developer lifestyle, if you will. Another disadvantage of the nomad freelance developer is that clients, how often can you get clients? Steadiness of the work, especially in the beginning, it's not so steady, that's for sure. First 6 months to a year, depending on who you are and your interpersonal skills, etc., it could take time before you get that off the ground where you have enough income coming in so that you can live a reasonable life. The positive aspect of that, of course, is that once you get it going, you can make much more money as a freelancer, nomad developer than you could working for somebody. Basic math. If somebody hires you at, let's say, $50 the hour, I'm just using that number, it will vary depending on where you live in the world and your level of skill, but let's say it's $50 the hour, they have to bill you out at least $100 for them to make money. So you can, when you are freelancing, you can make that $100 as opposed to only making the $50, right? Again, basic example, illustration of how this works, but yes, if you are self-employed, if you are a freelancer, nomad developer, you can, if you structure your business well and you with a little experience, you can make much more money as a solo coder than working for somebody, for sure. Another disadvantage of being a freelance developer is that you have to have your own equipment. You're gonna have to buy your own laptop. And that could be pretty expensive, although these days, $500 is more than enough on a laptop to be able to code anything in the world, really. But again, when you go work for somebody, they typically buy the laptop for you. They typically provide the software for you. Well, they always do, really. Whereas if you're freelancing, you're going to have to do that yourself. So there's that extra cost of equipment. That said, in at least in Canada, North America, and Europe, I'm sure, when you buy equipment for your business, you can deduct that off. You can deduct that cost off your taxes. So that is very cost effective. So I'm much more likely as a business owner personally to buy a piece of equipment because I know I can, the cost of that equipment is deductible off my taxable income. So that's a big advantage for sure as a freelancer, but you still have to buy that equipment. And the last disadvantage, I know I'm talking about disadvantages a lot, but trust me, I'm lifelong freelancer or SaaS owners, SaaS owner or SaaS's owners. Anyway, I've owned several SaaS's. I prefer that lifestyle personally. The last disadvantage though is that you're never stop working unless you're very disciplined. Meaning when you own your own business, whether you're freelancing or you have a SaaS, or a hot dog stand, you're always, the business is always on your mind, right? Because it's your business. And you're always thinking about growth. If business is not growing, it's dying. So when you work for somebody, you know, at the end of the week, on Friday, boom, you're done. That's it, over. You don't have to worry about the business anymore. When you're finished working in the evening, you don't have to worry about it anymore. Whereas when you own the business, you have to worry about it, right? So you're wondering if the client's going to pay, are you going to get this done on time, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. You don't have nearly as much of that when you work for somebody. That's why a lot of people, they like the idea of starting their own business. And then I've seen it several times. So when after working for years as professionals and highly performant professionals, they go start a business and they fold very quickly because they don't realize all the extra things you have to contend with as a business owner, even a freelancer. Although the first business I would advise anybody to get into is doing a little freelance, because practically zero startup cost, and you can get up running very quickly, and it'll teach you a lot about business in general without a huge investment that you might have otherwise. All right, I hope you find this useful. Yes, freelance development, nomad developer lifestyle is very cool, because you can work anywhere in the world. You're not bound to whatever the boss tells you. As the freelancer, you can dictate when you work, how you work, with whom you work. Whereas when you work for somebody, that's all set up for you. You don't really have much of a choice unless you quit. So there's a lot of freedom with freelance development, but with that freedom comes a lot more responsibility. But again, to me, by my experience, given my personality type, it's worth it. So if you're interested, you should just start dabbling a little bit, take it step by step and see how it goes. Oh, one other thing, when you're freelance development, especially in the beginning, you probably don't have coworkers around you. So it might be a bit of a lonely existence if you don't have a lot of friends around you. For me, it's never been an issue for me because I have a lot of friends, and I also live right in the heart of a city. So I just step out and meet people all the time. But keep that in mind, especially if you're working in the burbs, you might find yourself feeling a little bit isolated. Although these days with high-speed internet, it's not nearly as prevalent as it was back in the 90s, that's for sure. All right, bye-bye.